Previous class, we have studied the implicit differentiation. What is it and when we need to use it? Also, we have studied the derivatives of the inverse trigonometric functions. Today, we are going to mention how to find the derivative of the inverse function in general. And this is exercise 77 that they mentioned in the syllabus. So first of all, you know, ya shabab, that if you have an equation that contains x and y, two variables, and y is a function of x, you need here to find y prime, the derivative of y with respect to x. So here, the variable is x and y is the function. So what you will differentiate y here as a function of x. To use the implicit differentiation, you need to do only two steps. Differentiate both sides for the of the equation with respect to x, if you want to differentiate with respect to x. If there is another variable to differentiate to, you can do that also. You need to use the chain rule because y here is a function of x, and then solve the resulting equation for the derivative. As you can see, what we did, we just differentiate both sides, and then we solved the resulting equation for what? For y prime. We combine the similar terms, we put y prime alone on one side and then divide both sides by the coefficient. Now we solve it for y prime, and this is the derivative. Usually it will be in terms of x and y also. We did that also for several functions, and you have here several examples. When you have y prime in the second derivative, for example, in the first derivative, when you have the function, you can put the function instead if you have it. In the derivative, in the second derivative, if you have the derivative here, like here, and you have the derivative from before, you can use it to simplify the x separation, like what happened here. Also, if you have the original equation, you can also put it, use it to simplify the x separation, to make it in the most simpler possible form. Also, we mentioned in the previous class the derivative of the inverses, how to find them. In fact, you can use the implicit differentiation to find the derivatives. And we have summarized that in a table. In this table, we have mentioned what is the derivative of sine inverse, cosine inverse, tan inverse, and so on. You need to focus only on three. You need to remember what is the derivative of sine inverse. The derivative of the co-function, the cosine, it will be the same but negative. You need just to remember what is the derivative of tan inverse. It is 1 over 1 plus x squared. This is the same will be for cotan inverse. Log for cotan inverse, it is the same but negative. The same one but negative. Also, you need to remember what is the derivative of secant inverse. The derivative of its co-function will be the same, but with negative. And you can prove them, by the way, if you want. If you forget them, you can use just the definition of the inverse function and the implicit differentiation. You can prove it easily. We have also mentioned this example. It is all about the chain rule. Look here, you have y as a function of x here. So now apply the chain rule. Be careful, this is a reciprocal and this is the inverse. So the notation is important here. In fact, this one, it is just arc sine. So it is not reciprocal. When you take the derivative, you will apply the chain rule with the Bauer rule together and simplify your expression. Here you have arc tan, which is tan inverse. The derivative of tan inverse, I think this was the last part in the previous class. You know that the derivative of tan inverse of x, when you differentiate it, it is 1 over 1 plus x squared. And this is from the table. Here it is. Now, if you wanted to differentiate tan inverse square root of x, what you will do, you will apply the chain rule. It will be 1 plus what is inside here, square it. Here it was x, square x. Here it is square root of x, square the square root of x. But here you need to multiply by the derivative because this is not x, you need to multiply by 2 square root of x. Because here we have tan inverse of another function, not only x. This is how to differentiate tan inverse. For how to differentiate x times tan inverse square root of x, you need to apply the product rule. So this is what you are going to do to differentiate this function. You will say the first one, multiplied by the derivative of the second. This is the derivative of the second, shabab, log. This is the derivative of tan inverse. And then the tan inverse or the arctan of square root of x multiplied by x, which is the derivative of x is one. What is remaining is a simplifying. Simplify the expression to have the final answer. Today we will learn how to find the derivative in general. In general, not for the trigonometric functions only. So now, it is natural when you have a function, when you have y equals f of x, the derivative of y will be the derivative of f of x here. Now it is natural to ask yourself what will be the derivative of the inverse. So how it is related to the derivative of the function? If you have a function that is one to one, why here we mentioned one to one? Because we need to have the inverse, and you need, you know that the function is invertible, it has an inverse if it is one to one. Then, so if you have a function that is one to one and differentiable, then its inverse also will be differentiable. And this is very important. If the function is differentiable, then the inverse also is differentiable and is also one to one. Use the implicit differentiation to show that the derivative of the inverse, it is just one over the derivative evaluated at the inverse. And this is interesting. Look at the formula that we have here. This is the formula how to find the derivative of the inverse. What is it? The derivative of the inverse. The derivative of the inverse, this is the inverse. Derivative of the inverse evaluated at x equals to one over the derivative of the function evaluated at the inverse. So easy. Not difficult to be memorized at all. Just the reciprocal one over the derivative evaluated at the inverse. So this is why they use this notation, because in many situations the notation of the inverse is quite similar to the notation of the reciprocal. So how to prove that? Provided that the denominator is not zero. If the denominator is not zero, we cannot do that. Okay, now how to prove it, shabab? To prove it, you know that let's say that y is equals to the inverse of the function. According to the definition of the inverse, what will be x? X will be what? From here, shabab, x is
y.
X is f of y. This is the definition of the inverse function, shabab. So here we have f of y equals to x. Now differentiate this implicitly. Use the implicit differentiation to differentiate it. How to differentiate this? By using the implicit differentiation. Let me ask someone to help me with that. I'm gonna start over. Ahmed Shoud. Yeah, Ahmed.
Yes, Doctor.
Can you help me, Ahmed, how to differentiate this implicitly, yani, by using the implicit differentiation? Can you tell me what is the implicit differentiation? ايش بنسوي في implicit differentiation? أول خطوة هو خطوتين بس. في الخطوة الأولى ايش بنسوي؟ في الخطوة الثانية ايش بنسوي يا أحمد؟
Solve for y.
لا هذه step number two. Step number one, we will differentiate both sides. So differentiate both sides with respect to x. With respect to x. The second step, solve for y prime. اشتق الطرفين الحين بالنسبة لx يا أحمد. إيش الderivative حقة الf prime of y؟ لو ما عندك function of y. إيش الderivative تبعها؟
Derivative
of f at y,
by y prime.
Allah irda alayk. Exactly. This is the derivative of y multiplied by the derivative equals to what?
One.
Equals to one. Derivative of x with respect to x, it is one. Excellent. You are right. Thank you, Ahmed. So this is how to differentiate it, ya shabab, by using the implicit differentiation. It is the derivative of prime, f prime at y, multiplied by the derivative of the inner function. This is the chain rule. We apply the chain rule. Now we need to solve it for y prime. This is y prime. Solve it for y prime. It will be 1 over the derivative of f evaluated at y. But what is y? Now come here, replace y by what? By this, by the inverse. So look, instead of y, write just f inverse of x, and here instead of y, write f inverse of x. We have proved the formula. So just if you want to find the derivative, remember this, the derivative of the inverse of any function. Let's apply this for an example. In part B, this is exercise number 77. So if the value of the function at 4 is 5 and the derivative of 4 is 2 over 3, then what will be the derivative, the derivative of the inverse at 5? And I'm gonna ask Abdulaziz Asiri to help me. Abdulaziz, ايش راح تكون الفورمولا؟ ايش راح يكون الاف انفرس evaluated or the derivative of f inverse of 5؟ يا عبد العزيز. The derivative of f inverse at 5. According to this formula, it will be what? Abdulaziz. I see your name. Where are you, Abdulaziz? Abdulaziz, I cannot hear you. Abdulaziz Asiri. Allahumma hal ballagt, Allahumma fashhad. Abdulaziz Asiri is not responding. He is absent. Okay, let me go to Ahmed al-Jaber. Ya Ahmed, what will be the derivative of the inverse at 5?
It will be 1 over.
Derivative of the function evaluated at the
of f inverse 5.
At 5. Ahsanti Ahmed. Thank you. You are right. Now the question is
Kamal.
Khalas Ahmed, thank you. Thank you very much. I'm gonna ask Muhammad Zahir. Muhammad Zahir, what is f inverse at 5? What is f inverse at 5 equals what? Muhammad Zahir?
Yes.
Yes, Muhammad. F inverse at 5 equals what? من هنا يا محمد. Look at this. You can know it from here. It is 4. من التعريف حقة الانفرس يا محمد. محمد انت تدري انه لو قلنا ان الواي تساوي الاف انفرس اوف اكس، اذا الاف اوف واي هي الاكس. احنا قلنا هذا الكلام، استخدمناه هنا. اذا الحين انت عندك اف ات 4 ايكوالز تو 5. تعال بدل الحين، هذه كانت واي، هذه كانت اكس. تعال هنا حط هاي هنا راح تصير 4، حط هاي هنا راح تصير 5. سو اف انفرس اوف 5 از 4 فروم هير. So this is 1 over the derivative at 4. شلنا ال f inverse of 5 and we bought 4. And this will be equals to what, Muhammad?
1 over 2 over 3.
اللي هو الريسيبروكال حق 2 over 3 اللي هو 3 over 2.
Yes.
Excellent. So this is the value of the derivative at 5. Even we don't know what is the function, what is the inverse, but we can find it if we have these values. We need another example to understand it better. So this is exercise number 78 in your book. Show that this function is 1-to-1. How to show that this function is 1-to-1, Shabab? Do you remember from 001? How to show that this function is 1-to-1? طبعاً, you can use the definition, the original definition of the function that is 1-to-1, but sometimes it takes time, طبعاً. You know, if you have to show that if fx1 equals to f of x2, then this means that x1 equals to x2, or the another way around. So you need to show that. And it is not difficult, by the way, but there is an easier test for that.
Horizontal test.
Yes, if you can sketch the graph of this function, use the horizontal test. طبعاً, try to plot the graph of this function. You can make 5, 4 points as much as you can. But there is also very interesting theorem. I think if you have studied from my slides of math 001, I have mentioned there that if the function is increasing always, if you have a function that is increasing always or decreasing always, it will be always one-to-one. If you notice, this function is increasing always. This function is always increasing. Its graph will be increasing like this, always. And we will study in chapter 4, by the way. In chapter 4, we will study very interesting test that can tell you if the function is increasing or decreasing easily. What is the derivative of this, Shabab? This is what we are going to study in chapter 4. The derivative of this function is what? 1 plus
1 plus e to the x.
هذه الفانكشن يا شباب لو رسمناها هي نفسها الاي تو ذا باور اكس بس شفتد اب بدل ما هي عند ال1 راح تكون عند ال2 هذه هي هذه الفانكشن هي حقت الدريفيتيف ايش هي يا شباب انكريزنج ولا لا طبعا ات از بوزيتيف اي مين ات از بوزيتيف ذيس وات اي مينت سو ذيس وان از جريتر ذان 0 اولويز ات از ابوف 1 ات از اولويز بوزيتيف بما ان الدريفيتيف بوزيتيف اذا الفانكشن انكريزنج هذا راح ندرسه في شابتر 4 ان شاء الله If the function, if the derivative is positive always, then the function, if it is positive, wherever the function is positive, the function, the original function will be increasing. You can do that in several ways. You can use the definition, you can use the horizontal test, you can use the increasing test. So it is one-to-one, so this is not difficult. We can show it in several ways. Now let's find the value of F inverse at one. Who can tell me what is F inverse at one? It is not easy to find the Shabab F inverse. Can you find the F inverse here? Do you remember how to find the inverse if you have the function?
It's zero.
This is y equals to x e to the power x. To find the inverse, this will be difficult, ya Shabab, because you need to solve this equation for x. So it is not easy. You cannot solve this for e. If you wanted to take ln for both sides, it will be ln x plus e to the power x, and you cannot distribute here. So it is not easy to find f inverse of x. You cannot. But no need to find the inverse of the function in general. You need just to find the inverse of the function at one. So what you will do, you will bring your function. And you will put what equals to one? This is the function. You will put y equals to one. So this equals to one. One equals to x e to the power x. And find what is x. You know, ya Shabab, that this function is one to one. So if there is a value at which this function will be equals to one, it is one value only. يعني هاي راح تكون one at only one value of fx. وش هي؟ وش الفاليو هنا؟ You can guess what is that value. It is zero.
Zero.
So this will be one equals to one. So it is only when x equals to zero. ما في يا شباب غيرها. لو كان في غيرها كانت ما راح تكون one to one. So I'm sure that there is only one x that makes this equals to one, which is because of it is one to one. So it is easy to guess this value, not to solve it. It is not easy. And it is just the x-intercept, of course. Just put it equals to zero, and it will be the y-intercept, not the x-intercept. Excellent. So f inverse at one, it is zero. The question now, use the formula, this formula, to find the inverse of the derivative of the inverse at one. So just it is a matter of applying, Shabab. You will just write it as f inverse. Of one, the derivative of the inverse at one equals one over the derivative evaluated at the inverse at one. So this will be one over the derivative of what is f inverse of one? We have found it before, it is zero. So what is one over the derivative at zero? What is this? This is the function. What is the derivative? It is 1 plus e to the power x. What is the derivative evaluated at 0, Shabab?
2.
It will be 1 over e to the power 0. It is 1 plus 1. It is 2. So this is 1 over 2. Easy. Okay. Now I think you are ready to solve this exercise, Shabab. This is an old exam question. Yes, do you have a question?
Yes, how can you get two when you evaluate one? The last step,
it is the derivative from the formula. We have the derivative evaluated at the inverse. What is f inverse of one? We have found it here.
Yes, we have found it, but the f derivative of zero, how do you find it?
What is the derivative of the function? The function, it is x plus e to the power x. Its derivative is what?
One plus
e to the power x. Both x equals to zero because we need f prime at zero. Equals to zero.
Okay.
E to the power zero is one. One plus one is two.
Got it.
Okay, Shabab. Now solve this, please. Here you have the function with a condition. Do you remember why they give this condition? Usually this condition will make the function one-to-one. Without this condition, this is a parabola. Without this condition, it will not be one-to-one. So this is important to be considered. Find the derivative of the inverse at two. Yalla, ya Shabab. I will give you 2 minutes and I will launch polling for you to select the answer when you finish. Try to think, Shabab. If you are not thinking in a math class, in which class you will think? So try to activate your brain. If you didn't think, this is not good, because one of the main objective of this course is to help you to think and to improve your critical thinking. Unfortunately, some of you, they don't think only, they are thinking only during the exams, because there are new questions, new tricks, new ideas. When they are studying, they are not thinking. They are just memorizing, looking for solutions, the old exam solutions and so on. So they just not thinking at all. It is important. If you are thinking every day, what you are going to do in the exam will be very easy. It is also for me. If the questions are all easy, 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 I will not think. But if there is something new and new interesting idea, I will start thinking. And this is very good. MashaAllah, 7 students answered or response. Ya Shabab, take a paper and pen and start try to solve, not necessarily to solve in a correct way. If you got the right answer, this is good. But if you didn't, it's okay, because you are not in exam. You are still practicing. Only 14 students out of 41. So we have like today at least 2 students are absent. We have also some guests attending this class. Okay, I'm gonna give you a few seconds more to vote. And after that, I will end the polling. Let me see how many answers we have. Let me share with you the results. So 7 students went with A, 9 with B, C2, and E is 6 with E, none with D. Excellent. What do you think the right answer is? The right answer is
E.
It is A. It is A. Why, ya Shabab? ليش راح منكم السؤال? This is easy, direct application for what we did before. أنت ودك الderivative of the inverse at 2. ايش راح تكون؟ يعني ايش الفورمولا؟ 1 over the derivative of the inverse evaluated at 2. اذا انت الحين محتاج الاف انفرس ات 2. اوكي، كيف تجيب الاف انفرس ات 2؟ هذا اللي غلطتوا فيه، انا متاكد انكم غلطتوا هنا انتم. وش الاف انفرس اوف 2؟ هاو تو فايند ات؟ يو هاف تو ميثودز. يا اما تروح تجيب الانفرس اذا تقدر، اذا تقدر تجيب الانفرس جيب الانفرس بعدين حط مكان الاكس 2. This is one way. طبعا هنا تقدر تجيب الانفرس. You can find the inverse. Remember math 001 chapter 2.8 chapter 2. So this is not difficult. لكن انت ما تحتاج تجيب الانفرس. انت محتاج بس تجيب ال value of the inverse at 2. فايش راح تسوي؟ تعال هنا حط مكان ال f of x ايش؟ 2. Because we are talking about the inverse. Now solve this equation for what? For x. Am I right? Now which one will choose يا شباب؟ احنا هي 1 to 1، هي 1 to 1، فمستحيل تكون في 2 values، مستحيل. هي 1 1 value مو 2. فايش هي؟ هل هي square root of 2 or negative square root of 2؟ Look at the condition.
Negative.
Negative.
It is less than negative 1. So this is rejected. So x is what? X is less than negative 1. So x is negative square root of 2. So this is the value of the function. So f inverse of 2. لأنه هذه احنا سميناها x مثلا. F inverse of 2, it is negative square root of 2. نكمل. الآن this will be equals to 1 over. What is the derivative of the function? The derivative of the function, it is very easy. What is it? 6x minus 0. It is 6x. إذن هذه راح تكون 1. 6x evaluated at x equals negative square root of 2. So it will be 1 over 6 multiplied by negative square root of 2. So this will be what? 1 over negative. You need to rationalize, I think. It is 1 over 6. Multiplied by negative, let me write the negative here in the front. It will be one over 6 square root of 2. So look, if there is any positive answer, this is rejected, rejected, rejected. So it is between this and this because the answer is negative. Now just rationalize by multiplying by square root of 2. So it will be negative square root of 2 in the numerator. Here, square root of 2 times square root of 2 is 2. 2 times 6 is 12. So it is negative square root of 2 over 12. You have to be proud of yourself if you solve this question correctly. Yes.
The first step, how do you write it? 1 over of a prime of inverse of 2.
Are you with us from the beginning, Hashem? هذه الفورمولا خلاص اتفقنا عليها يا هاشم. وين رحت؟ هاشم.
Okay, 1 over
هذه الفورمولا اللي هي ثبتناها هنا، ترى احنا اشتغلناها لين حصلنا عليها. We have proved this. It is a ready formula. You have to use it. Yes. اذا ناسيها تقدر تثبتها يعني. ابدا من الانفرس، اكتب in terms of function implicit differentiation self solving for y prime، عوض بدل الواي بالانفرس. It is not difficult.
يعني اقدر احفظها وخلاص يعني ما تتغير.
Yes, it is in general for any one-to-one, for any one-to-one differentiable function.
Okay.
وطبقناها هنا يا هاشم. يعني استغرب سؤالك لأن كنت موجود معنا المفروض إلا إذا تجد متأخر.
لا موجود بس.
Any question, شباب, about this also? Any question here?
Yes, if you want to solve it with the first method.
أي first method?
To find the inverse, then. Put two.
ما فهمت قصدك.
To find the inverse of the equation.
قلت لك روح جيب الانفرس. بس ما تحتاج تجيب الانفرس. روح جيب الانفرس. هذه تحتاج تتذكر 2.8002 أول سكشن في ماث 002. كيف تجيب الانفرس؟ Put y equals to 3x squared minus 4. Solve it for x. You can solve it. Why not? وبعدين take the derivative. تحصل على نفس النتيجة. يعني اذا جبت الدرفه، اذا جبت الانفرس ما عاد تحتاج تسوي هذا الكلام كله. يعني اذا عندك الانفرس، if you have the inverse of the function equals to blah blah blah, differentiate it. But then evaluate that too. This is another way. But no need for that one because this will be shorter and easier. But you can use it if you have the function, yes. If and you can find the inverse.
Okay.
Okay, Shabab, I think this is enough for today. This is how to use the implicit differentiation, how to differentiate both sides. You will differentiate both sides with respect to x, and you will put after that x equals to 4 and y equals to 1, and you will find the slope of the tangent. I will leave this for you to practice, Shabab. There are many interesting questions here. This is about the inverse. How to find the derivative of the inverse at pi over 2. And I think it has a solution and you can practice a final answer. If you have, of course, start from now, from today, Shabab, practicing on this section. And if you have any question about it, you will be welcome during the office hours. I think this is enough for 3.5 and we need to go to 3.6. By the way, we are supposed to finish 3.7 this week, but unfortunately we will not be able to do that. No problem, we will catch up inshallah later. So let's go to 3.6, ya Shabab, to give you an introduction about this section because the time is not enough to have it all. So 3.6 is about what? It is about something that you have waiting for. I have received several questions about the differentiation or the logarithmic differentiation. Today we will see what is it. So we have here mainly three objectives. The first one is what is the derivative of the log or the ln? We didn't mention this before. What is the derivative of log a of x if you have y equals log a of x, or in general if you have y equals ln x of x, or in general if you have log of another function or ln of another function, what will be the derivative? We will answer this question today. And also, what is the logarithmic differentiation? Many students try to solve questions by multiplication or by the quotient rule or the product rule, and it was difficult and long. This kind or this method will make it very easy. And at the end, we will mention back the number e, the Euler number, how it can be expressed as a limit in a different way. Okay, now the derivative of the logarithm of b, the logarithm b of x is 1 over x ln b. So easy. So how it is true, why it is correct? Let me repeat, the derivative of the logarithm of x, the b logarithm of x, it is 1 over x ln b. If you have a function, Shabab, who can tell me if it is a function, if it is log b of g of x, mathalan? It will be 1 over what? Who can tell me?
Yes.
G of x multiplied by ln b multiplied by what? All of this multiplied by what?
Derivative of the gx.
The derivative of the inner function. This is in general. Now the question is, from where this one is coming? Is it correct how to obtain it? If I forget it, how can I prove it? How can I memorize it? So it is very easy. Now what you will do, you will put this equals to y. انت الحين السؤال, السؤال ايش هي الدريفيتيف حقت اللوج بي اوف اكس. يعني افرض انك مو عارف وش هي. ايش راح تسوي؟ راح تسوي هذه بواي. So this is step number one. You will put it equals to y. Now what you will do, you will use the exponential form. Do you remember the exponential form? Or you can of course, I think this is easier by the exponential form. You remember, ya Shabab, when you have log A of B equals to C, what does that mean? Let me read B of A. This means what? This means that B to the power C equals A, am I right?
Yes.
So this means that B to the power Y equals X. This is the logarithmic form, this is the exponential form. Now, differentiate this implicitly by using the implicit differentiation. So when you differentiate this, what will be the derivative of b to the power y? Do you remember? It is what? When you differentiate now, differentiate both sides with respect to x. Here, the derivative of the right-hand side, it will be 1. Now, the derivative of this side, it will be what?
by ln
b, y ln b. This is the derivative. You remember, Shabab, that the derivative of b to the power any function. First of all, you need to remember it for x. H derivative حقت b to the power x. When x is the variable, it is b to the power x ln b. If you have a function here, g prime, it will be the same, but you need just to multiply by the derivative. So here it will be b to the power y ln b equals to 1. Is that correct or there is a mistake here?
There is something.
We need to multiply by.
There is something missing here. We should multiply by what?
Derivative of y.
Because we are differentiating with respect to x. Log the derivative here with respect to x, not with respect to y. So correct. Now we need to solve it for what? For y prime. So solve it for y prime. If you solve it for y prime, you will divide by the coefficient. You will divide by this. So here we are. We are done. Which is y? Had y. The derivative of it is this. And we have proved that the derivative of the logarithm of b of x, it is 1 over x ln b. So it is just, Shabab, 1 over the argument, 1 over the argument, multiplied by ln b in the denominator. Excellent. طيب, لو كانت ln, يا شباب, إيش رأيكم? لو كانت ln x. You know that ln x, it is log e of x. So the derivative will be what? 1 over x ln e. It will be like this. What is ln e? Is 1. Ln e is 1.
1.
So it will be 1 over x. So it is much easier when you have ln. The derivative of ln x or ln x, it is 1 over x. Because ln e will be 1. So you need to recall these two formulas. Okay, now let's apply it for this example. Differentiate y equals ln x cubed plus 1. طبعاً يا شباب, 3.4, as I told you, it is the most important section in chapter 3. So 3.4 is important here. You will apply it in every example here. Now you have ln of another function. So you have two methods. The first method is to use directly the chair rule. So it will be the derivative of this function will be equals to, what is the derivative of ln? Ln whatever. When you differentiate it, the derivative will be 1 over that whatever multiplied by ln e, which is 1, and that's it. And you need to multiply by the derivative of that whatever. So here it will be 1 over g of x multiplied by the derivative of g of x. So this is one way. The another way is to use the substitution. So let me finish this way. So this will be 1 over what? What is g of x? It is x cubed plus 1 multiplied by the derivative, which is 3x squared. So simply, it will be what? In the denominator, we have the function. In the numerator, we have the derivative. Look how easy it is. So you don't need to do this step and this step and this step. You can go directly to here. The function will be in the denominator, the derivative will be in the numerator. So in general, the derivative of ln g of x will be g of x prime over g of x. Just like that. It is just a generalization for ln x. You know, for ln x, it is 1 over x. So this is the function, this is the derivative. So this is one way that I told you. The second way is to use the substitution. So y equals to ln u. Both this equals to u. U is x cubed plus 1. Now by the chair rule, what will be dy dx? Dy dx will be dy du, because the variable of y is u, times du dx, because the value of the variable of u is x. Now this will be equal to what? What is dy du? What is the derivative of this with respect to u? It is 1 over u times the derivative of this with respect to x. It is 3x squared. Substitute 1 over what is u? U, it is x cubed plus 1 times 3x squared. Simplify it, you will have this.
Doctor?
Yes.
How about if it was squared?
Which one?
cube plus 1 squared.
No problem. You will differentiate it again. So if it is like that, it is a good question. If it is ln, if it is ln x cubed plus 1 all squared, what it will be? It will be 1 over the same function as it is, and here multiplied by the derivative, by the derivative of x cubed plus 1 all squared. Now it is about the chain rule again. As I told you, Shabab, it is the most important rule that you have studied in this course, the chain rule. So it will be 1 over x cubed plus 1 all squared multiplied by the derivative of this one. Now, what is the derivative of this function, Shabab? You have a function raised to the power. So how to differentiate it? You will differentiate the power at the beginning, then differentiate the function. So this will be 2 times x cubed plus 1 multiplied by 3x squared. Is that clear?
Yes.
Yes, you should consider the chain rule. If you forget it, consider when you have to differentiate a function of another function. So in general, I have put here you have formulas for you in general. If you have, when you have a function of another function, the ln of u, when u is a function of x, it will be 1 over u du dx, or simply like this. How to differentiate ln g of x? It is g prime over g. Let's apply this for this one. I will ask who to help me. Faris Rashidi. Yalla, Faris. Let's solve this together, please, Faris. Is Faris here or he is absent? Sami'ni sawtak, Faris. Faris is not here. So let's go to Khalid Nubi. Khalid.
Yes, doctor.
يلا يا خالد خلينا نساعد سوا ساعدني help me to solve this. ايش نسوي؟ انا ودي اجيب derivative حقت لين لين ساين اكس.
طيب f of x على f prime of x.
كيف؟
f of x على
لين. نتذكر سوا نتذكر سوا يا راشد يا خالد. نتذكر سوا لما عندك لين of a function كيف تجيب الderivative؟ The derivative of ln of a function, it is the derivative over the function. يعني 1 over the function multiplied by the derivative. ببساطة أنت راح تطبق هذا بس.
يعني كوزين x على سين x.
الله يرضى عليك. بس انتهى الحل. ببساطة ln the derivative of ln sin x will be what? Sin x تحطها هنا في what is inside ln, what is inside ln, put it in the denominator. Now, اشتق اللي موجود عندك هنا. Sin x ايش الدرفتف تبعها؟ كوسين x. خليها في الدنومينيتور. And the answer, the final answer is cotan x if you want to simplify. أحسنت يا خالد. Excellent. Now, let's have another example. I will ask this time خالد الغامدي. خالد الغامدي, help me to differentiate this. The square root of ln x. Are you with us, Khaled?
So, can you hear me?
Yes. Yes, I do. كيف نشتق لما يا خالد لما يكون عندك square root of function. كيف تشتقها؟
We take derivative of g ln x.
لحظة لحظة. خلي انسى هاي انسى هاي. هاي هاي أنا قاعد أسألك عن هاي. What is the derivative of the square root of g of x?
Do we take a chain rule?
Yes, so it will be what?
Half gx. Yeah.
It will be like this, am I right?
Yeah.
Excellent. So remember how to differentiate square root of x. The derivative of square root of x, it is 1 over 2 square root of x. مضروب في الderivative حقت الx اللي هي 1. فلما يكون عندك هنا function غير الx, تضرب في الderivative. So here it is. Then okay, you are good. You are good, يا خالد. So the derivative of ln of x. الآن شيل هاي حط مكانها ln of x. So this will be ln x.
X.
تكون derivative حقت ln x. إيش derivative
حقت
ln x? Derivative حقت ln x. شيا.
One.
What? No, the derivative of ln x, ya Khaled. If the derivative حقت ln x. يا شباب في شباب بياخذوا غفوة وقت الكلاس وبعدين ما يركز ما يقدر يركز. The derivative of ln x يا خالد.
One over x.
One over x. ركز لو سمحت تكفى. So it Sorry. is one over x. إذا هاي الderivative حقت ln f x هي one over x. الحين بسط راح يصير عندك one over x all over this. So it will be in the denominator. It will be one over two x square root of ln x. Is that clear, شباب? Any question? Here it is. This is the answer. What we did, طبعاً, if you prefer to use the powers, you can write this as square root of two, one over two, and differentiate the power as he did here. But no need, it will be much clearer if you did this directly. No need to do this step. Okay, thank you, Khaled. Let me go to the next example with Mutlaq. Yalla ya Mutlaq, help me to solve this. Mutlaq Shimri.
Yes.
Log 10 of 2 plus sin x. خليني اذكرك هنا يعني. وش هي الderivative؟ الderivative حقت log b of g of x. لما ودنا نشتق هذه الفانكشن ايش الديريفيتيف
log of gx
راح تكون
ديريفيتيف log of gx over log of gx
ايش راح تكون يعني الخطوه اللي بعدها الفاينل انسر راح تكون ايش هنا يا مطلق ايش log b of x ايش الديريفيتيف حقت log b of x
1 over X
ln
log
B. Yes. Log B. Ln B. مش log. Ln B. طيب الحين هذه راح تكون إيش؟ هنا G of X مضروب في ln B وهنا مضروب في الدرفتين. So يلا يا خالد يلا يا مطلق الآن هذه الدرفتين حقت هذه الفانكشن إيش راح يكون؟ What we have here in the denominator?
GX.
اللي هي
log 10
لا طبق الرول الجي هنا هي اللي جوات اللوج يا مطلق اللي جوات اللوج مش اللوج كلها يعني اذا كتبت لي كل
اللوج
يا مطلق ترى تكفى يلا تحرك
كوساين اكس
ايش نكتب هنا في الدينومينيتور ما انت معي للاسف يا مطلق لو سمحت صح لو سمحت لا تقعد في الكلاس مشغول باشياء ثانيه ولما اجي اسالك ما تدري التطبيق مباشر ايش هي الجي هنا ايش هي الجي في حالتنا هذه هي الجي so this will be 2 plus sin x نفس الجي اللي قلنا عليها مضروبه في لين البي وش البي البي اللي هي لين 10 مضروبه في الدرفتيف حقه الجي يا مطلق الدرفتيف حقه الجي اللي قلت انت عليها اللي هي كوساين اكس That's it. ما في أي صعوبة في الموضوع. It is direct. هذه هي الإجابة. شوف نفس اللي كتبناها in a short word. Okay, شباب. I will stop here and we will continue. طبعاً here it is the same idea. راح تكون. خليني أكمل هذا الإجابة. We have one minute. إيش راح تكون الدرفتيف يا شباب؟ راح تكون one over الفانكشن نفسها زي ما هي مضروبة في الدرفتيف حقة اللي جوا يعني مضروبة هنا في المقام راح يكون عندك الدرفتيف حقة الفانكشن كلها وهنا تحتاج تطبق التشين رول لتطبق الكوشنت رول you need to apply the quotient rule or the product rule you can write it as d over dx في ال x minus 2 to the power negative half x plus 1 you need to apply the product rule or the quotient rule We will do that next class, inshallah, on Sunday. See you, Shabab, and have a nice weekend. Really, this week, inshallah, a nice weekend after the midterms. Good luck, Shabab, and see you, inshallah, on Sunday.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you.
Question, شباب, before I leave. Okay, thank you very much, شباب. Yes.
About the last written quiz.
I didn't grade it, inshallah. I will try to grade it during the weekend. You know, you were busy this week, and also we were busy.
Yes.
Morning we have classes, afternoon we have exams, and so on. So I didn't have time to grade it.
Okay, no problem.
Inshallah, during the weekend, I try to find time for that.
Okay, thank you.
Welcome, Ibrahim.